Bundy with Hogan to the buckle. Here comes Bundy.
A second avalanche.
Nobody, I mean nobody's going to get up from a second avalanche. Cover him, Bundy. Cover him. Bundy's demanding a five count, but he's not covering. Wait a minute, McMahon. His foot's touching Hogan's. That should be a legal count right there. His foot was touching Hogan.
New champion coming in by the free.
No, it should have been the championship anyway. Bundy's foot was touching Hogan's on that five count, McMahon. Deny that.
I can't deny that, but I can't deny this. Hulkster somehow back on his feet, reversing it. Here's Bundy to the buckle. Bundy to the back. Hulkster drops the leg. Cover that man. One, two, three.
No! This has been an injustice, that incompetent referee. He wasn't the referee that started the match for obvious reasons because of his incompetency. You saw it, McMahon. Bundy's foot was touching Hogan.
If Bundy had not been so greedy for the five count.
Oh, wait a minute. Look at this. Look at this.
I don't blame the big man Andre for being upset. You gotta be kidding. Hogan is gonna challenge Andre after the match Bundy just gave him? This idiot's gonna call Andre into the ring?
In the heat of the moment, the Hulkster likely to know anything.
Who is he taunting, the big man?
Andre the Giant could very well step between the ropes.
We might see another rematch of the century right here.
Nope, Andre.
What a smart guy, you know why? Money. This match ain't signed. There's been no determination of money. He's not gonna do it for free.
Andre the Giant. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Andre coming in now. The music playing. Hulkster closing. Andre from behind.
Head
back by Andre. Look at the look. Look at the look on Andre's face. Look at this.
I can't believe it. Hogan looks helpless to me.
Hulkster on his feet. Andre rocketing and down goes Hulk Hogan.
I can't believe it. Hogan looks helpless. Look at how small Hogan looks next to the size of Andre the Giant.
Come on, get
the camera and show those hands.
Somebody's got to do something about this.
Look at the size of those hands. Hogan's out. Cover
Here
him,
Here come
Andre.
The British Bulldogs from the dressing room area.
And they can't even hurt him.
Davey Boy, Dynamite, trying to hook Andre, trying to get him away from the Hulkster, trying to get those mammoth hands off of Hulk Hogan.
I can't believe it.
Look at this. Andre rounds them together. Andre with the British Bulldog sends him over the top rope.
Like two sacks of garbage to the floor, McMahon. And he's gonna go back up. Look at him yank Hogan up. Hogan is literally helpless. I'll tell you what, Hogan better never, ever step into the ring with this man again.
Andre the Giant, here comes the whole army now.
I don't even know if they're gonna help. Hogan is out. Hogan completely out. The JYD can't do nothing. Strike force hammering away on the Giant. Look at the tenacity of the Giant. They cannot get him off Hulk Hogan. Hogan down, out by the 7'5", 530-pound Andre the Giant.
Jake the Snake in there. Ever all in there. Finally, Andre releases it. Now he's going back for it again, I think. Yes, he's here comes Hacksaw Jim Duggun.
And he's got the 2x4.
Hacksaw's going to measure it. Who'd you hear that?
It did nothing. Andre's looking at him.
Andre going for Hacksaw Jim Duggun, who justifiably wants recovery. Meanwhile, they're trying to get the Hulkster out of there.
Well, I'll tell you, it's the 2x4 that saved Chump Hogan, because there was no way the big man was going to turn him loose, and that 2x4 had little or no effect.
I've never seen Andre the Giant so incensed. Look at this, Andre.
As far as I'm concerned, there's the champion of the world right there.
I've never seen Hulk Hogan carried from the ring like this.
Look at that man.
7 feet 4 inches over the 500-pound mark.
Look at
There was no justification.
Champion.
No justification for what Andre did.
No justification. Hogan challenged him into the ring. Hogan laid the belt down right where it's at, right there, and says, come on, big man. Well, he got it. We'll see if he ever tries that tactic again.
Andre the Giant making his way back to the dressing room. Saturday night main event continues.
Back with more Saturday night's main event, the nation's capital. We are told now that a medical team is back with the World Wrestling Federation champion Hulk Hogan. Hopefully we'll have a report on his condition later on. We'll also get word, hopefully, with Andre the Giant as to what prompted him to commit such vile acts. Let's take you now to Jesse the Body and his guests.
Happy New Year, Jimmy Hart and Greg the Hammer Valentine.
Hey, same to you, Jesse. You know, we sure are glad to see you instead of that other moron out here with a microphone.
McMahon?
No, the little short one, Okerlund.
He's around here somewhere. But you know, now that I'm a big movie star, I can do just about anything I want around here. And I want to wish you two the best of luck in your match tonight against Koko Beware and that foul, foul of his, Frankie.
You know, you always have a way with words, buddy.
Now, Greg, with the new year comes changes. And I, as a journalist, have to keep on top of these changes. And I have to ask you, how's your relationship so far with the Mouth of the South?
You know something, things couldn't be better. Jesse, I have never been happier in my entire life. Why anyone would be happier starting the brand new year off with one of the giants of professional wrestling, Jimmy Hart, instead of that metal midget, Brutus the Fruitcake.
You know, Jimmy, it seems like you've really got your wrestler mentally prepared.
Well, you know, Jesse, not even Rona Barrett or Barbara Walters gets to the meat of the story any better than you. Come on, Hammer, let's go, baby.
Ooh, that's up close and personal, Mean Gene, the hot air machine. Eat my dust.
Oh, yeah!
All right, I thank you, Rona. I beg your pardon, Jesse. Hey, Koko Beware. Greg the Hammer Valentine and Jimmy Hart sure seem cocky tonight.
Wait a minute, Mean Gene. It's nothing against you, Frankie. You see what I think about those dudes? They're nothing but featherweights.
Featherweights? What?
Featherweights!
Hear that, Frankie? Featherweights!
Featherweights!
You know, it seems to me that Greg the Hammer Valentine and Jimmy Hart talking more about Brutus Beefcake than they are talking about your big matchup.
Let me tell you one thing, Mean Gene. You see, I've been around Mr. Barber, and he's been telling me, brother, he's been teaching me how to clip the wings, brother, and that's just what might happen tonight.
Get ready, what a duel. Yeah. They are something else. Frankie, and of course, Koko Beware, they're on the way back to you, Vince.
Thank you, Gene. Koko Beware making his entrance into the squared circle here moments from now. Yes, here he comes. The foul driver, Koko Beware, and Koko must be leery of the figure four leg lock because Greg the Hammer Valentine.